A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th December. On the front page, you have Australians Day Out. So this is regarding Indian Premier League auction. So here you can see that in the auctions in Kolkata, players from Australia were bid the highest. Here you can see it was for 15.5 crores that Pat Cummins of Australia was taken in the team. Then this is two die in police firing in Mangaluru as anti-CAA protests rocked the country. So marchers have taken to the streets defying prohibitory orders in many places and braving police crackdowns. And here you can see two persons were killed in police firing in Mangaluru in Karnataka. And below you have US House impeaches President Donald Trump. So in US House of Representatives, US Donald Trump has been voted against. And but this is because in US House of Representatives, the lower house, Democrats have a majority, but the upper house also has to approve it. And in upper house, that is the Senate in USA, the Republican Party has majority, which is from where? From the party of Donald Trump. So it is highly unlikely that he would be impeached. But the Senate trial will begin next month now, because one house has voted for impeachment. On page 3, you have India Rankings Society to regulate NIRF rankings. So this is a separate body called India Ranking Society. This will administer the NIRF rankings from next academic year. So this is for institutions. So it's National Institutional Ranking Framework. So this has been confirmed by National Board of Accreditation. So National Board of Accreditation was the one which was accreditation, which was carrying out the task over the past few years of ranking of higher educational institutions, including professional institutions. So now this will be done by a separate body. On page 4, you have visa fee waiver scheme for Sri Lanka refugees yet to take off. So this is a scheme offering waiver of visa fee and overstay penalty for expediting voluntary repatriation of non-camp refugees from Sri Lanka. So this is yet to take off despite fewer years having passed since its inception, because so far only 1,230 non-camp refugees out of 1,257 applicants have received the waiver over the years. So the number of applicants only have been very low. On page 7, you have pact to open door for US defense firms. So industrial security annex, which has been signed between India and US at the second 2+2 dialogue in Washington, will open the door for US defense companies to partner with Indian private companies for several multi-billion dollar deals in the pipeline, like the 114 fighter jets for which bidding would begin as such. So this is there. The other agreements have already been signed. So the one which is remaining will also be discussed. So you can see. So Comcasa was the last one which was signed, that is Communications Compatibility and Security Agreement. And the one which is remaining out of 4 foundational agreements, defense related agreements, which US needs countries to sign for that so that it can cooperate with them on defense. So 3 have been signed. The 4th one is BECA, that is Basic Exchange and Cooperation Agreement for Geospatial Cooperation. So this is still under negotiations. So other one was also, you should know, GSOMA. So that is General Security of Military Information Agreement. So the Industrial Security Annex is actually part of this GSMO. And LEMOA has already been signed. So that is Logistics Exchange Memorandum of Understanding. So that was the first. The second came Comcasa. The third one is for GSMOIA, Industrial Security Annex, which has presently been signed. The only one remaining is BECA. Then this is Niti Aayog seeks ideas on population policy. So government think tank Niti Aayog has said that it will hold national consultations on population stabilization to explore ways to strengthen the country's population policy and family planning program. Then we had seen Prime Minister Narendra Modi has also raised this concern on 15th August on Independence Day. So Niti Aayog working paper to help India and its vision to attain population stabilization is being initiated now. And this is Portugal sets up Gandhi Prize. So Portuguese Prime Minister Antonio Costa has announced the setting up of a Gandhi Citizenship Education Prize while attending the second meeting of the National Committee for Commercialization of Mahatma Gandhi's 150th birth anniversary. So this has been announced by Portugal. And this is onion imports yet to bring price relief for customers. So though onions have been imported, the first onions imported by central government as such to counter the domestic shortage of onions and to bring down prices are set to enter the market. They are mostly in Delhi and Andhra Pradesh, but the prices have still not come down. You can see prices are as high as 160 in Chennai, 160 per kg of onion. And this is a national ration card which will be initiated. Central government has this ambitious initiative to, and a pilot project will be initiated in this for 6 states. So a ration card in a standard format, which will be same across the country. That is one nation, one ration card initiative will be started now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is protest in order. So this is regarding protests against Citizenship Amendment Act. So authorities should facilitate expression of views, not suppress rights, is what this article speaks of, editorial. And second is not unimpeachable. So President Trump is unlikely to be removed as president, but the rebuke will hurt him. So he cannot be impeached because the upper house he has majority, but still the process will bring rebuke for what wrongs he has committed. So you should know for what he's been impeached. He had put pressure on Ukrainian president to start investigation in the business dealings of Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden and his son. So he was trying to target his rivals through other countries. He had said that Ukraine will get assistance, and it was actually a fund release which was to be provided military aid of $391 million. So that would be given only if he initiates investigation. So this, and then this is one accusation on which he's been impeached. And second is that when the investigation started, he interfered in the investigation. So that is that abuse of power, urging witnesses not to cooperate. So these are also, this is the second ground on which impeachment is taking place. Then the lead article is enthralled to its own violence. So in the second innings, it is said Modi government has turned its back on conciliation with dire consequences for the polity. And here you have inaccurate diagnosis, draconian remedy. So this is regarding India's black money problem. It is said it was misdiagnosed, unverified, exaggerated numbers went into enactment of harsh laws. So to bring back black money, steps which the government has taken, how misinformed they were, misdiagnosed the problem was, is what this article is talking about. So here you can see there is this Black Money Act, which was a draconian law that was bound to fail. At a minimum tax rate of 60%, it gave marginal incentive for hoarders to come clean. Then on Fridays on the opinion page, you have parley coverage in which there is a question and view counter views given. So this is regarding, should the government exit Navratna companies? So BPCL's stake is being sold off, while BPCL is actually a profit-making entity and government does not have any loss, but rather profit through it. So disinvesting partial stakes is more fruitful than outright asset sale of PSUs. So this is the viewpoint which comes forth. This is a very important issue. And this is a tale of two demands. So this is regarding citizenship being demanded for Bangla refugees, but then it is said not on the basis of religion, because the Citizenship Amendment Act gives citizenship, facilitates citizenship for refugees, but for non-Muslims. Then this is, allow children right to protest, says UNICEF. So UNICEF has urged governments across the world to allow children the right to protest and appeal to its member states to refrain from violence and ensure their protection. Then this is, India clarifies on security of Afghan minorities. So Afghanistan has substantially addressed the security needs of the religious community of the country, is what External Affairs Ministry has said presently. So the clarification came after Home Minister Amit Shah urged in favor of Citizenship Amendment Act 2019, citing persecution of religious minorities in Afghanistan, Bangladesh, and Pakistan. So this clarification was sought, which was given to Afghanistan. So it says that it was about Taliban era, means there are no persecuted minorities present here. So that has created, you know, international problems too, like between nations problems. And below you have Citizenship Amendment Act paves the way for foreign aggression. So this is a petition filed in Supreme Court. So this has raised the argument that Citizenship Amendment Act is opening the nation to foreign aggression and internal disturbances. It also says that the government was not able to protect the country from internal disturbance. Then on page 11 you have section 144, a vestige of colonial rule. So this is the section which has been used as such, through which internet services are being shut down. So it is targeted as an insidious provision, as it confers almost unbridled powers upon executive officers. So where in somewhere internet is being shut down, somewhere police has detained protesters, somewhere you can see police firing is taking place. So as a response to public protest, section 144 is being ruthlessly used. This is section 144 of CRPC of 1973. On international page, you have this coverage on President Trump's impeachment in House of Representatives, which is there on the front page too, there, which we have been discussing for the last few days too. And this is regarding Scottish demand for referendum. So Scotland wants independence from UK, and it is seeking a referendum on this. And this is Sri Lanka will develop Matala Airport. So this is Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapakse, who said there is no discussion with India on the project. Earlier it was thought Matala Airport will be provided to India for development, because Hambantota Airport has been developed by China. China has presence over there. So for strategic reasons, we wanted Matala Airport. But Sri Lanka now says that this project is off the table for India now. Sri Lanka itself will develop the airport. Then on the business page, here you have RBI to conduct Operation Twist to manage yields on December 23. So banks will simultaneously buy and sell government securities. So this will be for $10,000 crores each, you know, government securities. So this will take place on December 23 under open market operations of RBI. So this is to manage the yields from government securities. So this is there. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asia.com. Thank you.